July 2019, Thailand. After being trapped in a cave for 2 weeks, 12 boys and their soccer coach were on the verge of being rescued. There was just one problem. To rescue the boys, divers had to escort them through a pitch-black flooded cave in a 3 to 4 hour journey. The boys were fully submerged in cold water for much of the trip. There were two major risks: panic. The boys could become frightened and struggle in the narrow underwater passages. Cold exposure. Spending hours in cold water could lead to hypothermia.
To prevent both, rescuers sedated the boys with ketamine. Ketamine has been used medically since the Vietnam War, where it was employed as a painkiller and field anesthetic. In recent years, its use has expanded from anesthetic for surgeries to an effective treatment for mental health issues, ranging from depression to PTSD. Because ketamine is also used as a veterinary anesthetic and a party drug, its reputation has been clouded. This has left many people confused about its role in modern medicine and unaware of its potential as a legitimate treatment. So in this video, we will explain how ketamine works, how it is being used medically from therapy to surgery, the effects it has on your body, and why it was the first choice for the rescue team in Thailand. Think about your daily commute to school or work. You take the same route every day. It's familiar, automatic, and maybe not even the best way to get there, but it's the path you're used to. Now imagine one morning you wake up and find that your usual route is completely blocked. Suddenly you have to take a detour. At first, it's confusing and maybe even frustrating, but as you explore different roads, you discover better, faster ways to get to where you need to go. That's exactly what happens in the brain when ketamine is introduced. Our brains communicate using chemical messengers. One of the most important ones is glutamate. Glutamate helps send signals between brain cells, like traffic directing cars on the road. When someone struggles with depression, anxiety, or PTSD, their brain gets stuck using the same old, less effective pathways, like taking a slow, inefficient route every day, even if it's not helping them feel better. Ketamine triggers a glutamate surge, which is like closing down the usual mental roads and forcing the brain to explore thousands of new detours all at once. Instead of just finding one new way, the brain rapidly creates and strengthens many new connections, making it more flexible and adaptable. This can help break people out of negative thought patterns, allow them to process emotions in a healthier way, and even help therapy work better. Over time, if these new pathways are reinforced, they can become stronger and more permanent, just like finding a better, faster way to school or work that you'll want to use every day. At high doses, ketamine shuts down entire highways, slowing brain communication so much that the glutamate surge fades. Instead of rewiring, the brain goes temporarily offline, which is why ketamine works as an anesthetic, stopping pain and awareness, like putting the brain on airplane mode. This deep shutdown is what makes ketamine such an effective anesthetic. By temporarily disconnecting the brain from sensory input, it prevents the perception of pain and awareness without completely stopping vital functions like breathing. Unlike traditional anesthetics, which fully suppress consciousness, ketamine puts the brain in a dissociative state, a unique form of unconsciousness where signals from the body no longer reach the mind in the usual way. This is why it's used in surgeries, emergency medicine, and trauma care, allowing patients to remain stable while their brain is essentially offline. When you use a lower dose of ketamine, the process works differently. Instead of fully shutting down brain activity, a small dose keeps your brain active, but in a different way. Rather than being knocked out or feeling numb, you enter a more heightened, focused state, almost like being in a dreamlike or floaty headspace, but still aware and alert. Ketamine still blocks certain brain receptors and triggers the formation of new connections, but instead of deep sedation, it creates a state where your mind is more open and flexible. In therapy, this can be incredibly powerful. The low dose helps unlock parts of the brain that are typically harder to access, allowing you to explore emotions, memories, and thought patterns from a new perspective. The glutamate surge sparks new neural pathways, making it easier to process trauma, shift those perspectives, and gain insights more quickly than with traditional talk therapy. This is why ketamine works faster than traditional antidepressants, and while it holds so much promise for treating depression, PTSD, and chronic pain. So what are the physiological effects of taking ketamine? It's not just about your brain, it's a full body experience. Ketamine affects multiple systems, including how you process pain. It has the ability to reduce the intensity of pain signals, essentially turning down the volume on discomfort. This is why it's used in medical settings for pain management and emergency situations, whether it's helping with acute pain or managing more chronic discomfort. This brings us back to the rescue mission in Thailand. Ketamine kept the boys calm and unconscious, preventing panic, hyperventilation, and drowning, especially since most couldn't swim. It also suppressed the shiver reflex, reducing energy loss. Normally, shivering helps generate heat, but it burns calories. By keeping the boys still and slowing their breathing, ketamine helped conserve body heat, but it wasn't enough on its own. Wetsuits trapped warmth, and careful handling by rescuers minimized exposure to cold water, preventing hypothermia. But ketamine doesn't just affect the body. It also alters how the brain processes reality. It's not just about physical effects. Ketamine also changes how your brain receives signals from the outside world. This is why you might feel detached from reality, almost like you're floating or observing yourself from outside your body. It's a feeling of separation from your usual sense of self, much like being in a dream. It's completely normal and part of your brain's process of resetting itself. Ketamine can also increase your heart rate and raise your blood pressure, which is why it's always used under medical supervision. But when managed carefully, these effects are nothing to worry about. Ketamine has had a mixed reputation, often seen as a party drug in the past. When used recreationally at higher doses, ketamine can cause a K-hole, an intense disorienting experience where you feel disconnected from your body and surroundings. This can be unpleasant, leading to anxiety and confusion. That's why it's important to avoid using ketamine outside of a medical setting. This should, however, in no way detract from ketamine's long history of safe medical use. Since the 1970s, it has been used as an anesthetic in surgeries and emergency situations, saving lives by disconnecting people from pain and awareness. Now you might be wondering, why do some people call ketamine a horse tranquilizer? The horse tranquilizer label comes from its veterinary use for large animals, but it was developed for humans first and is widely used in medicine today. The nickname stuck due to law enforcement messaging and media sensationalism in the 1990s, when recreational use and media coverage took off. But it's an oversimplification that doesn't reflect ketamine's true medical importance. Another concern people have is whether ketamine is addictive. Ketamine doesn't cause the same kind of physical addiction you might get with substances like nicotine, alcohol, or opioids. While it can lead to psychological dependence if used frequently in recreational settings, this is much less common when ketamine is used under medical supervision. In a controlled therapeutic environment, addiction is not a concern. Ketamine's potential in treating mental health is clear, but its effects vary greatly depending on the dose. That's why it's always essential to use ketamine under professional guidance to ensure it's used safely and effectively. Now that you're more informed about how ketamine works, it's time to take the next step. Click here to learn more about how ketamine compares to MDMA therapies and explore the exciting possibilities for mental health treatment.